Rahu in the seventh house gives more obsession towards the partner. The person is too obsessed with the partner. Now, if the partner is able to satisfy, then it is okay. Otherwise, the person gets into an extramarital relationship. So this leads to divorce or separation. And that is why Rahu in the seventh house has more to do with miseries and separation. Separation or divorce eventually leads you to misery. So the first point of Rahu in the seventh house is problems in the marriage. The second point about Rahu in the seventh house is that the focus is always on the others. So the person is extrovert and not introvert. And because of this nature, because of extrovert, being an extrovert, always interested to know about others, the focus within is no more in existence. So on a very ordinary level, in a very ordinary chart, the person is a gossiper. He just loves to gossip about others. Rahu is also a great cheater. And when Rahu is in the seventh house, the person often feels as if being cheated in relationship. I have seen many men and women who either have been cheated by their partner or who have ended up having a wrong partner, a partner who doesn't share anything that these people like. They are totally contrast. So Rahu in the seventh house is not at all a good position as far as the other is concerned, because the seventh house is the house of others. And who is the closest other person in your life? Obviously, your marriage partner or your girlfriend or boyfriend. And Rahu is desire, Ketu is desirelessness. Just yesterday I shared one post on LinkedIn. It was about Bhagwan Raman Maharshi. Bhagwan Raman Maharshi says that Maya is desire and God is the state of desirelessness. So you see, Rahu is this Maya which goes on giving birth to new desires. And in the case of Rahu in the seventh house, the whole focus, the whole desire is based on the matters of sexuality, matters of relationship and marriage. But there is always a saving point, and the saving point is based on the nakshatra in which Rahu is placed and whether Rahu is positive for your ascendant chart. If your ascendant is of Mercury, Venus. Then Rahu becomes positive for you. So in that scenario, now this 7th house Rahu will give you a lot of pleasures in relationship and with your partner, whether marriage or outside marriage. But if your ascendant belongs to the Dharma, what is Dharma? Which ascendant belongs to the Dharma Trikon? That is Leo, Aries and Sagittarius. So if your ascendant is Aries, Leo or Sagittarius, then Rahu will make your life more miserable, because Rahu is not comfortable for these ascendants. For these ascendants, that is Aries, Leo and Sagittarius, Ketu is beneficial and Rahu is the destructive force. Whereas for Libra, Aquarius and Gemini, Rahu is very positive. As well as for Taurus, Virgo and Capricorn, Rahu is very positive. It all depends on what ascendant you are born on. It is not that Rahu in the 7th house is bad for everybody. It depends on what ascendant you are born. Because that ascendant signifies the quality within you. Dharma or religious or righteousness is the quality of Leo, Aries and Sagittarius ascendant. And Rahu is against Dharma. Rahu is against religion. Rahu wants no rules. And religion is based on rules. So Rahu is never positive for these ascendants. That is Aries, Leo and Sagittarius. But the next triangle is of Taurus, Virgo and Capricorn. It is known as Earth Trikon. That is, it is related with earning money. It is materialistic. Rahu loves this. And so Rahu is positive for this ascendants. Taurus, Capricorn and Virgo. Whereas for Gemini, Libra and Aquarius, this triangle is highly related with intellectualism. It is related with air. These all are airy signs, Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. And Rahu is definitely related with air, because all the black magic or tantra, all this is related, all this happens through the air. So Rahu is very much connected with air, and these three ascendants, Libra, Gemini, Aquarius, they are also associated with air. So Rahu is always positive for these three ascendants. And then comes the Moksha Trikona, the spiritual triangle, that is Cancer, Scorpio and Pisces. For this, Rahu is becoming a danger. Rahu is not happy in this ascendants. So if you see, if you closely observe, then the Trikona of Leo, which is ruled by sun, and the trikona of Cancer, which is ruled by moon. For these two trikonas, that is Leo, Sagittarius and Aries, and Cancer, Scorpio and Pisces. For these two trikonas, Rahu is totally opposed, totally against. And who rules this trikon? Leo is ruled by Sun, Cancer is ruled by Moon. Sun and Moon both are the staunch enemies of Rahu. If you remember the mythology story, then it was the Sun and the Moon who exposed Rahu, the Asura, and that is when Vishnu beheaded Rahu, the demon. So the point is that astrology is not very generic. It is not something that 1 + 1 = 2. It has many conditions to it. So Rahu in the 7th house is bad only for 6 ascendant signs, which I just now explained. That is Leo, Sagittarius, Aries, Cancer, Scorpio and Pisces. Apart from these 6 ascendants, for the other 6 ascendants, Rahu in the 7th house is not bad. But now we will come to the most important point, the very last point, and that is the nakshatra in which Rahu is placed and the nakshatra lord. So if Rahu is placed in Bharani nakshatra in the 7th house and Venus is in the 8th house, then that Rahu will definitely cause trouble. Irrespective of which ascendant it is, it will definitely give certain trouble. If the ascendant is of the 6 ascendants that I just discussed, then the trouble will be more. But if the ascendant is of Mercury or Venus, then the trouble will be less, but trouble will be there, because the nakshatra lord in this case, in this example, is in the 8th house. Similarly, if Rahu is in the 7th house in Bharani nakshatra and Venus is in the 12th house, again this definitely gives issues in relationships and also in sexuality. Similarly, if Rahu is in the 7th house in Bharani nakshatra and Venus is in the 6th house, definitely divorce is possible, or either separation. So many such things are there in this Rahu in the 7th house subject. I have shared just a few with you. Maybe as this series goes on, I will share more. And I want to thank each one of you for all your comments. And I would only say the same thing again that I have been saying in all my podcasts, that remember to meditate every day, because astrology is just a small part of this ocean, which is spirituality. So spirituality is important. If you are spiritual, if you are meditating, only then will you be able to understand the true essence of astrology. I will be sharing more, just the way I have been sharing for last couple of years. So stay tuned and let the journey begin. Thank you and stay blessed. Jai Sri Ganesha. Jai Guru.